Hey there, how's it going everybody? In this video, we will talk about how to plot a bar plot like this in Python from scratch. Let's go. So first of all, we should import NumPy package, which is a package for doing numeric thing in Python. So we import NumPy as np, and when I say as np, I mean we are defining an aliasing, which is np for this NumPy package. And then we import matplotlib package, which is a package for plotting in Python. So we import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, and remember, when I say as plt, I mean we are defining an alias name, which is plt for this long-term matplotlib.pyplot. Why? Because we don't want to say that long-term matplotlib.pyplot. We want to use a shorter term, let's say plt, instead of that long-term matplotlib.pyplot. There it is. And then we define two variables, which is brands and market share Q1. And remember, our example is about the smartphone market share in the first quarter of the year 2020 for each brand. So we have a variable which is brands, which we have some brands here. You can see Huawei, Samsung, Apple, Xiaomi, Oppo, others. And the market share of each brand, the market share value of each brand in the first quarter of the year 2020. So we have a variable for each brand. And so we have a variable which is brands, that there is a list of brands, and we have another variable which is market share Q1, which is the market share value of each brand in the first quarter of the year 2020. And then we say plt.bar because we want to plot a bar plot, and we say plt.bar, and the x-axis of our chart is our brands, and the height of our chart and the height of each bar is the market share Q1, I mean the market share value for the first quarter of the year 2020. And there it is. And in the last line we say plt.show for showing the graph. And if we run the code, you can see there it is. Here is how to plot a simple bar plot in Python. Okay, please pay attention that we can't plot this bar plot another way. For example, we can define a variable called xx, and remember this xx name is completely arbitrary. You can define it another way. For example, you can name it a, b, c, d, e, f, g, or whatever name you want, but I want to name this variable xx. There it is. And we define a variable xx, and we say np.array. We define an array which contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So it has 6 numbers in it. So we want to set our x-axis of our chart to be this xx variable. And there it is. If we run the code, you can see the x-axis is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But there is a problem. And that is, we want to replace these ticks, I mean 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, with these brand names, I mean Huawei, Samsung, and etc. So we can use the xticks function to do this. So we say plt.xticks, and we say ticks is equals to xx. I mean, we are saying that, hey, xticks function, the ticks are the xx variable, and the labels are the brands. I mean, we are replacing xx with the brand's name. There it is. And if we run the code, you can see that there it is. Here is how to plot a bar plot in Python.